रिम झिम गिरे सावन सुलग सुलग जाए मन, भीगे आज इस मौसम में लगी कैसी ये अगन। रिम झिम गिरे सावन। फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू दिस ब्यूटिफुल वर्षा ऋतु। वेन वी टॉक अबाउट वर्षा ऋतु, वी रिमेंबर डायरेक्टली आवर स्कूल डेज, दोज डेज ऑफ वेयरिंग अ रेनकोट, पैडलिंग इन वाटर, थ्रोइंग स्टोन्स एट योर फ्रेंड्स, एंड लेटर ऑन गेटिंग वेट टुगेदर। यस, एंड उसमें मजा। सिरीश भाई, आई एग्री विथ यू, इट वॉज ऑल फन। सो फर्स्ट ट्रेन्स, ऑल ऑफ अस आर वेटिंग फॉर मोर देन अ कपल ऑफ रीजन्स, द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट बींग दैट वी आर ऑल रियली रियली wanting to have a respite from the torturing heat. And then the rains came lashing in Kerala 10 days back, and they have lashed our Mumbai city a couple of days back. I said this song of Kishore Kumar from Manzil, Rim Jim Gire Savan Sulag Sulag Jayaman, but bhige aaj is mausam mein lagi kaisi ye agan. Kishore Kumar talks about different type of agan, but here we are talking about agan only, but what the diseases, the problems which come with monsoon. So today we are going to discuss what homeopathy has to offer in the common illnesses of monsoon. You know, sir, Hari bhai, doctors are very happy when monsoon comes. the reason being, can we have this fan close, both of these? They are making too much of different noises. So doctors become a bit happy when monsoon comes. They look at the rim jim. What happens? The farmers also look, kab aayega barish aayegi, and doctors also look, kab aayega barish, because all the illnesses start. There's a slack for all the medical practitioners in these 2 months, because most of them travel. Most of the patients travel everywhere. Bombay also, it's pleasure traveling on the roads of Mumbai, because there is no one, there is no traffic. So people come back, monsoon comes back, and the illnesses start. But primarily the illnesses start in monsoon because of water, contamination of the water. Waterborne diseases is common, and all these diseases occur because of impure water. So if one boils the water regularly and drinks only potable water which is doubly filtered or boiled, then these illnesses will definitely come down. But there are some illnesses which are not dependent upon, you see, these only water, but also the weather also plays a part. Let us now see the common illnesses which occur or get aggravated in the monsoon season. The asthma and the other respiratory states, the skin states, the rheumatic complaints come because there is a lot of moisture, there is a lot of humidity, the digestive system, which comes because of waterborne diseases, and the sprains and falls. Now this is something else, because of the rains, because of imperfect walk, we tend to fall. So I wouldn't like to name anyone here. I just say it's a combined thing because of a lot of faculties together. So these are the common states we discuss. Today's lecture is short and sweet. This is the bread and butter of the doctors, and the most common complaints. People come, jab se barsaat shuru hui, doctor sahab, continuous khansi aa rahi hai, continuous sardi aa rahi hai. Aur kya hota hai? Sardi, khansi, bukhar, badan dard, all these things are coming together. The first thing which comes in mind, Shirish ji, when people talk about back pain and pains and a bit of shivering, is malaria, dengue fever, okay, leptospirosis. All these illnesses come along with malaria, and a good doctor has to be diligent to understand that it is not just plain fever, but also these things to be taken into account. So as doctors, and even as people who enjoy healthcare so much, you must get your CBC and ESR done. Some people may say that, what is the need? Take one close in, it will come down. But no, CBC, ESR has to be done. If the ESR is high, if the CBC is altered, if the MP test is positive, if the platelet count is down, then one must suspect all these things, and then subsequently go for dengue antibodies and all these things. But fever with chills and back pains, this should raise important alarm. Now we've got quite a few drugs in the armory. The child goes out, gets wet in the first rains, he enjoys his time, fantastic time in the building with his friends. He comes home running and is greeted by a big scold from his mother. Kaay asa kelas, kalat nahi ka tula? This is what I've heard so many years and still here. Kahi kalat nahi, ajibat, ya doctor zala azun tera kalat nahi kahi? 20 saal pehle wohi sunta tha. But moms are moms after all. So the mom gets a towel and she wipes it. So important that the head should not be kept cold for long. The problem is when there is a change in the temperature. If the head is kept cold in a warm room, the problem starts. But if the child is getting drenched continuously in the rains, nothing may happen because everywhere the vatavaran tasas hai. So when a child comes home, it has to be wiped. The thing has to be wiped. But such complaints, when they come, the child in the night suddenly develops fever. And we ask the question, kya hua? And when the mom says ki bheeg gaya tha, pura sar bheeg gaya tha, we give a drug called as Belladonna, which is a very important drug for getting wet in the rain, especially the head getting wet. We have another drug which is very important for cold, cough and fever, is the Arrhenia Diadema. It's a spider remedy, the Dulcamara and the Antim Tart. I am also a teacher in medical college, so in the medical students we have to make them understand ki, what are the symptoms. If you make them understand, they'll write down the notes and probably keep it till the exams and forget after the exams. So what is Dulcamara? Very simple, very simple. Urmila Matondkar running, yaile yaile dumrakke machore. So when someone waddles in water and walks in water for long, in knee deep water, okay, and develops feet pains and fever and chills, the drug of choice is Dulcamara. Will you ever forget, Shirish bhai? Will not forget. Remember Rangila scene. Yeah, Dulcamara is Rangila Urmila Matondkar. Fine. So this is Dulcamara, Arrhenia Diadema, Antim Tart. Very peculiar. You know, most of the houses are leaking. Most of them. The new house is also leaking, the old house is also leaking. Jahan leaking nahi hai, wahan pe pani gal raha hai. So basically everything is leaking. And what happens is that even if your house is not leaking, your walls are all moist and damp. And many times you get that typical smell of dampness. Especially when you go to these dark bungalows which are not maintained well. Out of Bombay when you stay sometimes, saste mein milta hai kabhi to apun rehte udhar jaake. But kya hota hai, all are damp. And when you stay in such damp areas, these cellars, okay, anywhere, maybe your home or outside, where everything is damp, you stay there, you sleep overnight, even the blanket which you take is also a bit moist, and you develop sudden chest infection, you develop fever, you develop a wheezing cough. The drug of choice, Lal Sahab, is antimonium tart. Antimonium tart, where the phlegm gets accumulated here, the child feels sleepy, he feels pukey, and when you auscultate, when you put your stethoscope on the chest, you will get a grr, 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 which is called as, sir, Subramanji, is called as wheezing, wheezing, right? Rustox is our remedy. Also for these states of bone pains, back pains, I have used Rustox quite many times in dengue fever, in malaria, and also in leptospirosis, because these fevers come along with muscle pain, back pain. Now these fevers, I'll say here very candidly, as homeopaths, I don't treat patients with dengue because these are life-threatening diseases. You have to send them preferably to Kasturba Hospital or these hospitals where have infection, a special ward for meant for these. Okay, so you can't take chances. But what happens after these people are discharged, still they keep on getting these pains everywhere, which lasts for a long time. And this is called as reactive arthritis. Reactive arthritis. Patients getting pain almost for 2 months, 3 months, 4 months. And such patients are treated beautifully with Rustox, Arnica, and also drug of choice, Pyrogen. Pyrogen. Reactive arthritis, which means inflammatory arthritis, or post-febrile arthritis. This is a whole group coming under reactive arthritis. They are not those patients with rheumatoid arthritis. Reactive means after some illness, they start getting some autoantibodies and they get sudden swelling of the joints. So these are the common complaints, gentlemen. People with asthma, people with COPDs are not very happy. They are the most happy in March, April, May of Mumbai type of climate. They say that we cannot take the rainy season of Mumbai. It's rather sinister. We prefer going to places like Pune or Baroda, where the atmosphere is not so humid and so moist. These patients have a tough time, and asthma can be treated very well with these drugs, apart from the constitutional medicine which you are giving, arsenic alb, natrum sulf, and antim tart. Natrum sulf is one of our very important remedies. There is something called as constitutions, which has been described vividly by a gentleman doctor called as Gravogel or Gravogla. He said that these types are the hydrogenoid constitutions. By hydrogenoid, we mean patient who are having tendency for accumulation of water, patient tendency to get swellings, patient tendency to get affected by moist atmosphere, moist climate, wherever the water accumulation. Natrum sulf is one of our good remedies for such hydrogenoid constitutions. Natrum sulf is also one of the biochemic medicines of Schussler, the 12 biochemic remedies which Schussler has discovered. Natrum sulf is also one of those remedies, and it will help many in these asthmatic states. Friends, let me reiterate what I always say. In homeopathy, there is nothing called as specific. These are just guidelines. I can tell you more than 50 drugs for the same states. This is just a guideline and just a sort of a bird's eye view of what can be useful homeopathically in these states. But ultimately, homeopathy is very individualistic. One patient comes, we have to go through a detailed case taking. So we may give more than what drugs have been listed here. Arsenic alb is also known for its periodicity, which means that the patient says that mujhe sujan aati hai har ek saal aati hai, mujhe pairon mein sujan aati hai sirf monsoon mein aati hai, mujhe sirf raat mein sujan aati hai. I get only these complaints at a particular time. That is called as periodicity. And Arrhenia diadema and arsenic alb are known for these periodic city states. Another complaint, skin complaints, fungal infection, so common. If you see closely the webs, the fingers, the toes of our housemaids, you will see they have a lot of these white thing between their fingers of the toes. Waiters also, hopefully we won't go to eat there. Yeah, so now let's have, but least said the better. I feel the most plush looking places from outside may not be